じゃあまず最初に、このプロジェクトの話を聞いた時にはどう思われましたか？
Well, I was super excited because I am very interested in Japan and very interested in video games. So this was a perfect opportunity to get closer to video game music and your work. And I had a perfect excuse to spend a lot of time on playing Xenogears Chronicles, Xenoblade Chronicles, to get closer to to your music, and that was interesting.
Thank you very much.
And so, yeah, very interesting request, and we've had a good time.
Really.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. No. I totally agree. it's not a request that you get every day, and we love recording music. It was also like a new request or a new task for us. We didn't try this before, doing these kinds of arrangements in that way of other music, and it's also a creative process for us listening to your music and how to make it put our little stamp on it also. That was a really interesting process, and we had a lot of fun doing these arrangements, and yeah, so it was a great experience for us, really.
Yeah, and also to feel your music, to feel your way of working with music is very interesting, and even though we live very far away from each other and come from two different parts of the world, it seems like we have a lot in common in the interest of music. So it was very interesting to open up your compositions, your works, and put ourselves into it, and it was actually very easy because it's very related to what we were.
It felt very natural.
Yeah, it felt very
natural.
So, あとアレンジ4曲あったんですけど、この担当どうやって決められたんでしょうか？
I think that was just a feeling. We had several different pieces to choose between. And it was very much just like a feeling.
Very spontaneous.
Yeah.
Quick. We listen to the tunes.
Yeah.
This one.
Yeah.
I'll do
this
that
one.
Yeah.
This one hits.
Yeah. And this one. No, listen to the next. Oh, that one. Yes. And that's like, and it also fits very good our personalities. Like the tunes we picked were very well suited for us as individuals also. So like Rune picked one tune, which he arranged, and I arranged one, and Nikolai arranged two, they were really natural for us as individuals, and it was very quick, just decision, perfect, you know. So it was easy.
Yeah. じゃあそのレコーディングを終えてみてどうでしたでしょうかっていう。
We feel great.
Great?
Yeah. Really wonderful.
Yeah, me too.
I'm so happy. Yeah.
We're happy it turned out the way you did. Yeah. You know, because you never know if you arrange it on your own and if you rehearse it as a trio, for example. But now in the studio, we are adding lots of other instruments. Yeah. So now we can hear what it sounds like, you know. So the feeling is great, and we're happy with
and we saw, hey, this was a really, really good day.
Yeah,
we had a really, really good day together. We are in an amazing studio, recording studio here in Tokyo. The equipment is just great. Mm-hmm. The atmosphere is great. Good stuff.
Yeah,
and, you know, it's just a really fun day where we can play with your music and be creative. So what a gift.
Luxurious.
But it's also really satisfying, like after a day, and we have like four pieces of music, right, and it's in the computer, it's right there just waiting to for people to listen to it, and still needs to be mixed, of course, and all these things, but it's a mix between something really satisfying and still with a lot of expectations of what people are going to think about it. I feel pretty confident that it works quite well because the music is great, and we had a lot of fun doing it. So
I noticed, I did some research, I noticed there were quite a lot of people making covers on these tunes on YouTube, for example. So it was it was an honor to you know, be able to work directly with with the mastermind and to be able to do this.
Thank you. じゃあ最後に、多分これもう20年来のクロノクロスのファンの方がですね、多分聞くと、多くの方が聞くと思うんですけれども、そのファンの方にぜひ最後にメッセージを一人ずついただけますでしょうか。
Yeah, well, I think what is very important、when you listen to the new recordings、as a listener, you have to be very openfor the new ideas and the new direction that these pieces went through. It's 20 years ago you wrote these pieces and the music scene has developed a lot since then. And you gave us the opportunity to play this music in our way. So it is different than it sounded like back then. So please open your ears and open your mind and take in the music as a new experience.
I came to think about that in some ways this is a similar process to what we do every day, because we all grew up with traditional music and you have something original and then you interpret it and you make it to something of your own. And this is sort of the same process we did with your music. We had these old recordings, 20-year-old recordings, and we interpreted them in our way and we made it into something of 2019. And or something of with our stamp on it, like we said before. So that's what it is. It's an interpretation. It was an honor to be part of, and I hope the people will enjoy it.
Yeah, it's related. So the music that you wrote has like very clear images and stories. And we are maybe telling a slightly different story, but we try to make every piece like a clear character. And that is always important for us to, with all our music actually, that every single piece has a very clear message. And that message might be a little bit different than you originally thought, but still we try to be like, keep the spirit of the music in the best.
Honor the tradition.
The compositions, because it deserves.
Really. It must also be nice for them to hear a recording with acoustic instruments and, because I guess the older ones were more like computer generated, a lot of it. Yeah. So this is more organic kind of version, which must be interesting to hear. I would love to hear other music I grew up with also in this way. I mean, it must be fantastic for them to be able to hear this music in this way.
Okay.
I hope they buy it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for letting us destroy your music. But thank you. It's a great honor. So thanks for the invitation.
Today is thank you so much.